Optics is a branch of study that had developed years back, and it deals with light and how we human beings perceive the world around us and how we are able to see. Now, if you take a close look at the picture on the board, you will see that a man is trying to read the morning newspaper. Now, if you look closely, you will find that there are spectacles that are in front of the man. Now, notice that when the man is not viewing the paper through the spectacles, the morning paper is appearing very blurred and hazy, as you can see. Even the morning cup of coffee that the man will be drinking appears blurred and hazy if he is not looking through the eyeglasses. But the moment the man is looking through the eyeglasses, you can see that he is able to perceive and see everything very clearly. So what do you think is happening? What is the mystery behind these eyeglasses? Now, do you know what these eyeglasses are made up of? These eyeglasses are made up of lenses. So what are lenses? Let us find out. Now, before we talk about lenses, look at another picture. Don't you see a very ugly and scary looking monster? Now, do you think it is a monster at all? Let me surprise you by saying that this is actually the picture of an ant, the small ant that you find at your home and in so many places around the world. So how do you think we were able to obtain such a large picture of this ant? The answer to that again is lens. Now let us see how this picture was obtained, how a small object can be made so big. This is a microscope. A microscope is a device that can help us to see small objects much larger. In other words, it magnifies the size of small objects. Do you know what microscopes use to achieve this purpose? The answer again is lenses. Now, lenses are not only used to make small things appear big or hazy things appear clear. Lenses are also used to see distant objects. In this picture, you will find Galileo Galilei using an object to see distant, far-off planets. Now, Galileo Galilei was an astronomer who lived long back in the 15th, 16th century. Now, this object that he is using is known as a telescope. With the help of the telescope, Galileo was able to observe planets that were very far away from Earth and study them. Now, do you know what a telescope uses? The answer again is lenses. So, what is a lens? Let us define lens. Lens is a transparent medium which has at least one curved surface. Notice that it should be transparent and it should have at least one curved surface. Also notice that a lens should not have any reflecting or shiny surface, because in that case, reflection will take place and it will defeat the purpose of a lens. Secondly, light after passing through the lens will undergo refraction. Why? Because lenses are most often made of glass, and light normally is traveling through air. So when this light hits the air-glass interface, refraction takes place. Now notice this picture. These two objects are lenses. Now these are lenses of different shapes and sizes. It is with the help of these lenses that human life has been made very convenient and easy. The previous examples that we considered of the microscope, of the telescope, all of these objects use these kind of lenses and many more to achieve their objective. Likewise, these are also certain lenses that are used all around the world. Now let me tell you something very interesting. In the picture, you will notice the eyes of a human being. Now, did you know that the eyes of a human being are also lenses? That's right. This is how we are able to see, because our eyes or a human being's eyes are also lenses, and they help us see the world around us. So it is not only inanimate objects that use lenses. We human beings have lenses in our very own body. Even a camera which a photographer uses or your dad uses to capture a photograph of you and your mom is also containing lenses. It is through these lenses that light enters and your dad is able to capture a beautiful image of you and your mom. So what did we learn? We learned that lenses are a medium which has at least one curved surface. Notice that a lens should always be a transparent medium and it should always have at least one curved surface. Also, we learned that a lens should not have any reflecting surface. Why? Because the reflecting surface is only present in case of a mirror. And if a lens were to have a reflecting surface, then it would completely defeat the purpose of a lens. We also learned the various places where lenses are used: microscopes, telescopes, cameras, and even the human eyes.